the people who wanted to know or who wanted to get the guest papers or with the previous examination questions along with their answers for MEG4 aspects of language. Here is a presentation. I can say that here is a PDF where you can actually get to know the important questions and solved answers. So this is for all the distance learning people. So the contents will have acknowledgements and then previous year question papers along with the answers of the important questions. I acknowledge all you people for all the support, and there are even people who are selling this notes like for a subject 250 and all, but then I wanted the people who just wanted to make use of internet and other facilities and wanted to still qualify in the exam. So this is for all of them. So these are the important questions and these are the previous year question papers, December 15th, June 16th and December 16th, June 17th, December 17th, June 18th, December 18th, and let me give you the answers of the important questions. Write a short note on word formation by reduplication. Reduplication in linguistics is a morphological process in which the root or stem of the word or a part of it is repeated exactly with slight change. Like you can simply say that reduplication is used in inflections to convey grammatical functions such as plurality and intensification, etc. Before moving on, go through all the contents. If you want, you can pause the video and then you can learn a bit. Quantifiers in English. Actually, what are quantifiers? Quantifiers generally appear in front of nouns, like all of the children, all I have, in all have returned, also with the pronouns. It is a type of determiner, like all, some, or much. Like it gives the quantity, like indefinite quantity or relative quantity, like how many, how much, all these things. Here in all politicians, all is a quantifier. And when it comes to partitives and quantifiers, like partitives are like somewhat, somehow, like that. Explain the functions of intonation in English and major tones. Intonation is like the rise and fall of the pitch, where you can tell the same sentence in two different ways. Like, get me the water, or give me a pen, or something like in a commanding way. Give me the pen, get me the water. It is the same sentence, but use the speaker will convey the emotions or attitudes in different range. define bilingualism? See, all of us will know at least one language, but if you know two languages, it is called bilingualism. And if you know multiple languages, like more than two, then you are called as multilinguistic. So bilingualism is commonly the people who use at least two languages. And this bilingual experience is unique to each and every individual. What, according to Grice, is meant by the cooperative principle and its maxims explain and exemplify conversational implications. What is cooperative principle in the sense? In general, it is like how people interact with one another. Some can interact like the people of different types, say ambivert, extrovert or something. And some of them will have a nature where they'll be so polite and some of them will be like so strict and some of them will have that commanding tone. So each and every individual will have their own interaction funda. And while speaking, both the listeners and speakers must speak cooperatively and mutually to accept each other and to understand in the same way. These are some of the examples by Maxim. Let us see about one example. Do not say what you believe to be false. And the same thing can be like, do not say that for which you lack adequate evidence. This is max of quantity. Likewise, we have max of relation, relevance and manner, be clear. And to be in order, like avoid obscurity of expression, avoid ambiguity, or you can just say be brief. Next thing, write a detailed note on the rise of American English. Actually, while Britishers have come to India, though they have trade and all these things as reasons. Another thing is to make English as a common language for conversation, like the common medium. And here, the American usage of English can also be like colloquial and formal also. Colloquial is what we use in general, like in our daily life, normally, like in the casual way. Formal is any way that is accepted by the standards with all the formal measures and all. What is meant by style in language and what are its uses? Different styles of expression in each and every language. But when I say style, it is a dress of thought or it is a manner. Like everyone will have their own individual style. from written to spoken styles. Because knowing a language is not just the written format, it is the speaking thing as well. What is meant by structuralism in the field of linguistics? Like Ferdinand de Saussure's course in general linguistics, like his colleagues after his death, and based on this note, the analysis will focus not only on the general use of language called parole or speech. Actually, language, this lang came from the Latin word, and parole is a speech. And according to Saussure, the linguistic science will be of two parts, that is a signifier, which means the sound pattern of the word. And the other one is signified, which means the concept or meaning of the word. So it is the sound and also the meaning. Write short notes on competence and performance. So when you can say that someone is having competence and someone can do the performance. Competence is the ability, like to communicate or to know the language, and the way we should have this good understanding and communicating skill in our daily communication or the use of language is called a competence. But then when we are able to get that into a practical implementation, then it is called performance. So though we have competence, we should be able to perform. Performance means what we do with our knowledge of certain language. And to know the language, we have to understand and we have to have the basic understanding of the language. That is called competence. Our linguistic performance will indicate our competence. How do competence and performance apply to the language classroom? Obviously, when you are competent enough and if you perform well, you will be a good speaker and listener as well. But in a classroom, if you encourage the students, though they make mistakes in the beginning, they'll try to learn. Not just the students, like even the experts do mistakes at times. So it is all about learning every day on a daily basis. If you try to learn and if you have a balanced focus on your competence and performance, you can excel with your language proficiency and your communicative approach. What does register mean in English language? And a distinction, that means the difference between register and dialect. Dialect is the regional variation of language. That is, if there are two groups and one is dominating, the other one is in the normal way. Or here we can say in the definition format as no two authorities can agree on same accent. That is what a dialect is. When a dialect becomes a separate language, if suppose your friend is talking to someone, the other way it would probably written in the newspaper or reported in the newspaper, say, is in conversational register, or you can also say generalistic register. It is true that conversational register is likely to occur in dialect than the generalistic register. And dialect is the regional variation or their own accent to speak a language. And what are cardinal vowels? The vowels are the sound of language. Here I can say that feet, when I say feet as a cardinal vowel, it means these are referenced vowels. When we say vowels, A, E, I, O, U are vowels as far as you know, and consonants are the remaining 21. But then they are not actual vowels. Vowels are the vowel sounds of A, E, I, O, U. If you say university for vowels, but that U will have Y sound. So that is a consonant sound. So though university have U as the vowel, but it is not having vowel sound of U, it is having Y, university. So at times you have to be clear with your vowel sound, and then you can call it as a vowel. For the cardinal vowel, I can say it as feet. And here they have given some articulary definitions. Vowel is produced with the tongue as far forward as a high in the mouth as it is possible, like without any friction, or your lips don't need to be spread, or with the tongue as far back and as high as the mouth is possible, with protruded lips. Write a short note on Pidgins and Creoles. Pidgin is a restricted language which arises for the purpose of communication between two social groups, like the dominant position than the other. And the less dominant group is Pidgin. And their history, like from where they evolved, like in the colonial situations with the officials, tradesmen and sailors. Like if someone from the foreign country comes to your country and if they try to sell something, so their language will be different and our language will be different. But we are trying to buy the goods. So the person who have come from the other country, and if they try to sell with the basic common knowledge, like if they wanted to sell opium, like which is a drug actually, but then if they wanted to sell opium, they'll only say opium and they'll only give the cost. They'll not have further conversation because both of them are having the understanding of different languages. So that dominant group whatever we call here, सो द लेस डोमिनेंट ग्रुप इज ए पिटगिन ग्रुप. And next, the differences between European and American structuralism. It'll have number of features. Let me take you to that. Yeah. Sorry for the delay. So they share common number of features. We have two different people, the great people like Sapir and Benjamin Leavor. Sapir work always attracted for more of the anthropologically inclined American linguistics. Like the most distinctive manifestation of the American structuralism. Relationship between literary criticism and stylistics. Which literary criticism is like complex or the changing group of disciplines, while the stylistics is the study or the interpretation of text from a linguistic perspective. The main difference will be like the opinion and the submission to analyze and evaluate literature. Stylistics will be like to study the style or pattern using literary or verbal language, whereas literary is the practical implication of literary theory. Whereas the criticism follows the object approach and stylistics will be of subjective approach. What are consonants? I've already told you, right? The remaining 21 sounds, except A, E, I, O, U sound, are called consonants. And that will be produced by the speech, I mean, partial or complete obstruction of aid stream by the constriction of the speech organs. And there are 24 consonant sounds in the English accent. What do you understand by this term, language planning? Describe the practical consideration that need to be taken into account by the language planners. Language planning is the effort to change the language or its function in the society. like corpus planning with linguistic purism and all, and status planning and acquisition planning. Acquisition planning is like influencing the teaching. Scope and negation. Negation as a logical operation with the examples and different kinds of negation. Negation is the like negative or opposite gesture where we reject the behavior of others, or we exclude it, or we disagree with something. It can be easily mastered because humans will have these negations if they don't like something. If humans have the strongest desires and likes, they'll have the same towards the strongest rejection on something. So negation can also be called as a logic. So we'll see the usage of negation in natural language. With the pre-logic sense to reject or to displeasure an undesirable situation or object, or with the usage of word no, which also means refusing. As well as if you deny a request or a command or an act. And the other form is to comment on the other's failure to achieve their goal, and to compare and quantify the scalar values like non-existing and the concept of zero. Short note on langue and parole. As we know that langue, with the French meaning language, and parole, which means speech, which are linguistic terms differentiated by Ferdinand de Saussure in his course of general linguistics. Discuss salient points of Bloomfield's theory and structuralism. Like Bloomfield is the one, like Leonard Bloomfield have most of his contributions into linguistics, which is mostly into American linguistic, because he is a philologist and American linguistic as well. And he has his representation into this American structuralism with the analysis and the way he viewed it in terms of a semantic aspect. Distinguish between vowels and consonants with the criteria of classification. Consonant is a sound of spoken language with the constriction or closure at one or more points along the vocal tract. I can say vowels and consonants are different sounds with the place of articulation with the vocal tract, such as bilabial, alveolar and velar. The 5 and the remaining 21. And the same thing can be compared with the letters like hat and hate. Both of them has A, but then hat will differ from hate. The sounds will vary. depending on the word and how it is combined with other vowels. What is intonation? I already said intonation is the rise and fall of pitch, like how a sentence sounds if it's a question, or how it's different from a sentence if it is a statement. Bilingualism, like with two languages, an individual says that. And the key goals of paper: to spread awareness, to describe social and environmental factors and the consequences and implications of bilingualism. I'm scrolling them fast so that you can pause at some point of this video, and then you can make a note, or you can just quickly read. What do you understand by this question? Language variation. Why does this variation occur? Variation in language is generally due to the speakers or group of speakers who have the concern of their sociolinguistics, like with their accent or with their word choice. I can say decent, dignified, or I can use the word which describes, or I can use the word of my choice to describe anything, and I can also I can also pronounce it in the way that I feel comfortable. Suppose Indian accent will differ from the American accent, and even American accent will differ from British accent. Like some of them say water, and some of them say water, and even the word choice, like some of them say holidays or halls. Some of them will go on vacation. What is morphology? And inflectional and derivation morphology. Morphology is generally given by the German poet or novelist or playwright and the philosopher Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. Morph is the study of forms. Generally, in linguistic, morphology refers to the mental system involved in the word formation. Suppose if I say ripe, R-I-P-E. Ripe is a word, so that is a morpheme. And if I say ripen, like I'm just adding N, then that N is another morpheme, ripe is another morpheme. So in the same word, ripe is a morpheme and N, ripen is also a word. Ripe is also a word. But the word which can stand alone is a free morpheme. And the word which cannot stand alone is called a bound morpheme. Like in ripen, N cannot stand alone as a single word. And ripe can stand. Same thing with the complete, completed. D is bound morpheme, complete is free morpheme. Where complete can stand alone, completed, that D, individual D, cannot stand alone. And morphemes will usually use either affixes, prefixes, or suffixes. And we can say that derivational morphology is like to change the meaning of the word by applying derivations. And in most of the languages, inflectional morphology marks relations such as person, number, case, gender, position. And in most of the language, in some of the languages, they'll not use it, or they'll use it in a minimal. Short note on code mixing. This is another important question, like code mixing and code switching. Code mixing refers to mixing of two or more languages or languages with variety of speech, whereas code switching will interchange it. Like in the multilingual thing, we'll use code mixing where speakers share more than one language. Some linguistics use the terms code mixing and code switching with an interchangeable format, but the terms are used to refer the elements from distinct systems. Code mixing will emphasize on the formal aspects of language structures or the linguistic competence. And the code switching will emphasize on linguistic performance. Like code switching will occur on the speaker when alternates between two or more languages in context of a single conversation. Short note on speech community. Speech community is like any community is a group of people. Likewise, speech community is a group of people who will share the set of norms or expectations regarding the use of the language. Like exactly how to define it in the sense. In the literature, they involve varying degrees with the shared community membership, shared linguistic communication. Previously in the language planning, we have seen language planning, status planning, corpus planning, and acquisition planning. Here they are asking about status planning, where it is used by variety of non-governmental organizations and the government organizations and even individuals. The main thing is like planning decisions and possibly changing for the benefit of the communication or to improve the effective communication with respect to improve a language speaking thing, and which will also lead to the changes in the society such as shift or assimilation by providing motivation to plan the structure and function of the languages. And their history, like how Spanish entered Peru, is there. Please do pause and read wherever you feel like you can learn more. Formation of Old English. Like most of them say that English is not just from the Western or Eastern or the South Asian thing. It has Borrowed from different things. Yeah, there is another question called borrowing, which means like getting words from other language or giving words to other language. I mean, where people tend to get words which are not there, which are not existing in the language, or by replacing their own language words. And generally, there are number of words in this internet generation, like this due to this globalization and glocalization, where English is basically a Western Germanic language that is originated from Anglo-Frisian dialects brought to Britain by Germanic invaders or settlers in the various parts of Northwest Germany and Netherlands. Initially, this old English used to have a diverse group of dialects, which means the variation in the regional language groups, which reflected the Anglo-Saxon kingdoms of Britain with the dialects of the Westo-Saxon, and eventually they used to become predominant. Yeah, English is developed into very much by borrowing languages with an enormously disparate vocabulary. Disparate vocabulary. Characteristics that distinguish human language from other animal systems of communications. Give suitable example. See, the animals can sense using various things. Like they use sounds, like the birds which make sounds, and they also sense with the order, like with the body order of the other person, they can sense what are the other animals which are existing. And the communications are not unique to human beings of this systems of communication. Animals will have variety of ways with the body movement, with the sound, with the order. But for us in the linguistic anthropology, human communication can be verbal or non-verbal. And some of them even say that based on the sounds due to poo-poo, poo or pish or ding-dong theories, which eventually led to the formation of the language when no one knows the language. Short note on compounds of English. Like, we combine two words, free morphemes and bound morphemes, and we create a new word with noun and all. But compounds are not limited to two words. Define speech acts. Speech is uttering words. Act is to like express with an action or the way of communicating. Speech acts are like staple in everyday communication or every communicative life. At least in the English-speaking world, speech act theory has an influential, not just with the philosophy, but also with the linguistics and psychology and legal theory, and also with the artificial intelligence and the literary theory, with many other disciplines. Discuss the examples, the different sentences types in English. Most of all, I mean, most of everything we know, the beauty of the sentence will lie in the clarity, like the way we make the people understand and the way we choose the words, the way we present our thought effectively. If like to a necklace, how the pearls are important, likewise our words and the way we pronounce it, everything matters to a sentence. In any form of writing, words, thought, ideas should be played well so that they are used as the building blocks to arrange or to structure or to organize simple sentences and compound sentences by combining multiple independent clauses and even complex sentences with at least one independent and one dependent clause and compound complex sentences with multiple independent clauses, at least one dependent clause, and interrogative sentences like question asking them, and by purpose like I am happy, the bird is flying, and exclamatory sentence which means expressing something, emotion or excitement, like good night, what a beautiful sunrise, like there is an excitement, wow, what a dream. Imperative sentence. Word sentences, single word sentences. What is the standard language and various stages of standardization? Standard languages is like when a certain dialect begins to be used in the written form normally throughout the broader area, then that dialect itself is a standard language. Because there should not be more of linguistic variation. There should not be more of the same usage and all. We have to stabilize the linguistic norms. We have to formalize and we have to follow certain standards so that we all agree to get into a same dialect, one local dialect. And one way of speaking, one way of writing, one way of understanding, one way to pronounce. All these stages. Thank you. Hope it helps. Anywhere, if you get any other deviation or anything, you can just pause and you can read.